everybody. I know there's still about 4 or 5 minutes left to go in the Monday Night Football game, but it is over. It's been over. But I'll talk about that a little bit later. So, week 16. Teams are fighting for playoff positioning and whatnot. And, well, we have some new eliminations this week as Alvin Kamara ran for 6 touchdowns on the Vikings. Vikings, you guys are out 6-9. It's not going to get it done. Not in the NFC. And the Saints have won the NFC South for the 4th consecutive year. And congrats to the Saints. They punched their ticket to the playoffs. The Lions, on the other hand, as we move from Christmas Day, yes, I know, a Christmas Day game, right? Crazy stuff, right? To Saturday, the Bucks beat up on the Lions. Absolutely disgusting. I mean, Tom Brady tossed 4 touchdowns. The Bucks seem to be locked in at the 5 seed in the NFC right now, but we'll see what happens there. Also on Saturday, Cardinals. You guys, hey, what's going on out there? You lost to the 49ers. Despite the fact that Robbie Gould missed like three kicks, he missed like an extra point, like 2 field goals or something. Despite all that, Cardinals just couldn't get anything going. They couldn't get anything going in this game. And, you know, they needed to pick up pace. They needed to get something going. And this was not the way to show it. And now you have allowed somebody to get the position. And we'll talk about that somebody in a moment. But 49ers with a big victory. Great morale boost. George Kittle came back in and did some things out there. And instead of Nick Mullins, I think it was C.J. Beathard. C.J. Beathard. That was the quarterback for the 49ers in this game. I mean, come on. Cardinals, your playoff lives are on the line here. You gotta get a little bit better than that. Meanwhile, also on Saturday is about the most ridiculous thing I have ever seen. The Raiders blew it. I thought the Dolphins were going to blow this game away. I'm talking about the Dolphins-Raiders game, because I mean, the Raiders had the win in their hands, and all it took was some bad defense. I mean, you don't just go all over Ryan Fitzpatrick's face mask like that. And it's like, how? The Fitz magic lives on in Miami. You know, and Tua, I'm not sure if he got hurt or something. He might have gotten pulled for something. I don't know what in the world happened. But I'm just so glad to see, you know, Miami look good. And they looked damn good against the Raiders. The Raiders are also now eliminated from playoff contention. It's kind of disappointing. Not going to lie to you. I mean, we were talking about this at the same time last year. I don't know if I had a video on that last year or not, but we were talking about this at the same time last year. Raiders completely collapsed once again. This is on everybody. This is on Gruden. This is on Carr. This is on everybody. What an utter collapse of the season. I mean, how do you had playoffs in your sights, and then you start to crumble and fade away? Once the Chiefs beat them on Sunday night a couple weeks ago, you know, I was thinking, hey, something's going on here. They're allowing points at a crazy rate. I mean, you don't allow 30 points and expect to get to the playoffs. Except for maybe potentially one team, but we'll talk about that team later. Y'all know who that team is. But Raiders, it's rather sad. Yeah, the Dolphins stay alive in the playoff hunt. Ravens also stay alive on the playoff hunt. They easily take care of the Giants. Giants need some help now to win the NFC East. And they actually got the help they needed on Sunday as well to win the NFC East. We'll talk about the NFC East in a moment. The rest of the NFC East, anyway. But yeah, Ravens is still alive. The Jets. I know, right? The Jets. Second week in a row that they have won a game. They beat the Browns. They beat them pretty... The score is a lot closer than indicated. Because the Browns just did not look good on offense. That's how the story's been several weeks now out of the season. The Browns have just not looked the greatest on offense. And I don't know what in the world was going on out there. I mean, yes, I get it. COVID took out all of your wide receivers. But this is the Jets we're talking about here. You can't go out and perform like that. Hopefully everybody is back next week. I don't know what in the world the NFL's problem is with COVID, but we already discussed that 3 weeks ago, how bad it was with the whole COVID situation and how they handled the Ravens, you know, and stuff like that. And how they handled the Titans, too, just terrible. And couldn't handle the Broncos correctly, couldn't handle the Browns correctly. You know, it's just whatever. You know, it's whatever, man. It's whatever. I mean, you got to protect those playoff teams, right? For that money, right? Yeah. But yeah, these Jets have essentially, they are now probably going to be the two pick. Yeah, they're probably going to be the two pick. And guess who's number one? Oh, those Jags. And boy, did the Jags get beat by the Bears. They got beat pretty bad. And the Bears have now moved into position. They are now the seventh seed, I think. And they are in great position to go to the playoffs if they win next week. Now, so, how about Trevor Lawrence, Jacksonville? Y'all want Trevor? The marriage is about to be set to happen. Poor Trevor Lawrence. But man, oh man. Poor Jags. So the tank didn't go as planned for the Jets. You know, perfect season gone for the Jets. You know, I mean, it's just everything just went wrong. Now the Jets have won. But, I mean, congrats to the Jets. I mean, they won games. I mean, there's no denying that. But there's also the negatives and all the people that really want the Jets to tank. I mean, I know Jags fans were cheering at the sight of the Jags, you know, looking like trash. But, I mean, the art of the tank is real. And it is very, very interesting to watch unfold. Meanwhile, how about those Chiefs? They have locked up the number one seed. They will get the bye in the AFC. You know, they already won the AFC West. Now they get the bye. The Falcons, you know, I think they blew another lead. It's really, you know, not even a joke at this point. It's just sad that the Falcons have pretty much blown it away. They could have had a good season. They could be in the playoff mix right now, but they just had to blow it, you know, so many times against teams. It's absolutely disgusting. Bengals get a win against the Texans. That helps Miami as far as the draft stock goes, because I believe the Texans are, what, fourth right now in draft positioning? That could change. I don't know. But, yeah, Texans, not a good season either. And Deshaun Watson is, he's got to get out of there. He's got to get out of Houston right about now. Houston is back to the way they were before he came to the league, you know, back to being trash. Get out of Houston, man. Get out of Houston. And meanwhile, how about those Steelers? Steelers come back. They were down 24-7. They scored 21 straight, you know, and they beat the Colts. I mean, hey, they beat the Colts. Now the Colts are on the outside looking in right now. I believe so, if I'm not mistaken. Colts are on the outside looking in. Steelers, you know, they got another victory. They finally got some morale back and everything like that. And they just need to start playing better. That's really the only thing here. Colts, nothing to really be sad about. You just gotta win next week, though. Gotta get a W next week in order to go to the playoffs. This is a strong team, you know, very strong team. I don't know how in the world they gave up three touchdowns like that, but, you know, a strong team is a strong team, and both of these teams, very strong, gave us a pretty good game, you know, towards the end. Now, the Chargers, they're looking to, you know, get some momentum going the next season. Hopefully they don't blow it away, you know, just completely blow leads and stuff like that, you know, next season. They get a good victory against the Broncos. You know, Broncos are pretty interesting. They're a pretty interesting team. I've only watched them about one or two times play all season long. And Chargers are interesting, too. I've only watched them play about one or two times all season long. But both these teams, you know, I mean, their seasons were over several weeks ago. So, you know, it is what it is. So, sir. Those Cowboys beat up on the Eagles. We're talking beat them up. I mean, Jalen Hurts threw about three interceptions, way too many. And people were whining, you know, people were crying, you know, Carson Wentz. Carson Wentz is better than Jalen Hurts. Jalen Hurts is better than Carson Wentz. Well, I say, finally, finally. Because last year, I know last year, we got beat by the Eagles last year. And they knocked us out the playoff picture last year. They really did. And I was so upset. But this year, we knocked them out of the playoff picture. I am so glad. Because there's been so many times where the Eagles have knocked us, knocked the Dallas Cowboys out the playoff picture. They've knocked them out so many times. 2008, one of the worst losses I've ever seen in my entire life. 44-6, I remember that. So bad. Whichever year we went 8-8 three straight times, and the Eagles were the ones that got the victory on Sunday night to end the season. Absolutely disgusting. And then last year, just disgusting. But this time, we get the W. We're alive. No thanks to the Panthers, you know. Shout out to the Panthers. You know, they got a victory against the Washington football team. And guess who got released today? Dwayne Haskins. Oh, my God. He got released. Oh, my God. That's so hilarious. Oh, my God. That's great. Dwayne, did you have a good time? Did you have a good time in Washington, baby? Did you have a good time at the strip club, baby? Did you? You did. It's okay. Go to the strip club again, my dude. Go live it up. Get out of Washington. It is hell. That field is hell. That team is hell. It is a terrible team. And despite all that, you know who gets that Sunday night? You know, that primetime slot next week, you know, that last game of the season, that damn football team with no name. How about that? C.D. Lamb and Amari Cooper and Michael Gallup go off. And Andy Dalton throwing spirals and stuff like that, yet the whole world gets subjected to the football team and the E-girls on Sunday night. Come on now. But I'll talk about that on Thursday, you know. But yeah, okay, the game just finished up. Bills beat the Patriots 38-9. Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. I mean, I don't know what in the world to say to that. I mean, Bills just are looking like a damn good team. They're looking pretty good right now. I think they're in the 2 position right now, if I'm not mistaken. They should be. Yeah, they are, because they had the tiebreaker over the Steelers. So, Josh Allen, Stephon Diggs, and company are still doing work, and they got one more game until the playoffs to prove their worth. You know, I'll tell you what did prove any worth was the Sunday night game we got. Packers, Titans in the snow, and, I mean, Aaron Rodgers is probably going to win the MVP. I thought it was going to be Russell Wilson. You know, for the first month or so of the season, I mean, obviously there's Patrick Mahomes, but Aaron Rodgers has thrown 40-plus touchdowns. Unbelievable. Unbelievable stuff right there. And they blow out the Titans 40-14. Blew them out. Blew them out the water. Straight up beat them. You know? Just, man, crazy stuff, man. Crazy stuff. Packers are pretty much a lock for the number one seed in the NFC, if I'm not mistaken. If they beat the Bears next week, they'll have the number one seed. And if not, and if things, you know, get a little weird, and the Seahawks and the Saints have a chance at the number one seed. Speaking of those Seahawks, they have pretty much locked up the NFC West. I believe they clinched it yesterday with a big victory against the Rams. The Rams looked awful on offense. I mean, there was one drive where they, instead of, you know, kicking a field goal to keep it close, you know, to keep it at a reasonable score, you decide to go for it on fourth and goal at like the 3-yard line and don't get it. I don't understand what coach's problems is with just taking the points. Just take the points. There was still like There was still a whole quarter left to go. There was still like a quarter and a half left to go, and the Rams still decided to go for it. I don't get that. I don't get that. And the Seahawks made them pay by pretty much stuffing them all day on defense, forcing them to kick only field goals, and just playing damn good, you know, on both sides of the ball. Yeah, 20-9 might not be pretty in some people's eyes, but in the Seattle Seahawks' eyes, it was pretty. Pretty damn good. So, there you go. Week 16, I've got all the games wrapped up here, my thoughts on them and stuff like that. And again, you know, come on down, like, share, comment, subscribe, click the little notification bell, and all that good stuff. I'll talk to you guys about the NFL, you know, week 17, because there is a lot going on in week 17, and it's going to get real interesting, you know, this week. So, see you later. Talk to y'all tomorrow.